In the lecture about cropping, we have cropped an image and resized it for use on the internet. In this lecture, we will look at how to save an image for the web. And in the next lecture, we will look at how to save an image for print. I have opened Save for Web. I go to File, Export As. Behind Name, you can give your file a different name. Below Save in Folder, you can change the place where you want to save the file. By default, you save in the same folder as the image is placed that you have opened. At the bottom left, we see Select File Type. When you click on it, you see a list with different file types. The two most used web file types are JPEG and PNG. Let's have a look at which file type is best suited for which type of image. I will start with JPEG. I scroll down until I see JPEG image. I click on it. At the top, we see our file name now ends with .jpg. I click on Export. The export image as JPEG window opens. Click on Show Preview in Image window. JPEGs are for photographic images. With JPEG, it's best to leave quality at 100% or close to 100%. This is because JPEG uses lossy compression, which means that you can damage your image if you compress too much. This is what the JPEG looks like if you compress too much. I click on the Show Preview button to compare with and without compression. So compression with JPEG is a trade-off between file size, shown below the quality slider, and image quality. At maximum quality, the file size is 150 kilobyte. At quality 98, we have already lost 50 kilobyte, a third of the size. And if I click on the preview button, I see the compression isn't noticeable. To save the image, click on Export. The next format is PNG. Because PNG uses a lossless compression, which means compression without losing image quality, PNG is the best choice for saving logos and icons. First, we'll look at what happens when I save our photo in the PNG format. I go to File, Export As again. At the bottom, I scroll down and click on PNG image. At the top, I see my file name now ends with .png. I click on Export. With PNG, you can always leave the compression at level 9, which is the highest compression level, because you can't see the compression. Because there's nothing to compare, we don't have a preview button as we had with JPEG. At the highest compression level, we see the PNG image is 200 kilobyte, so twice the size as the JPEG image. When we had compressed the JPEG image more, the size would have been 3 or 4 times larger. This shows that JPEG is better suited for photographic images. Now we will look at the advantages of PNG over JPEG when saving logos and icons. Open the Udemy logo. The Udemy logo has transparency, as we can see from the checkerboard pattern. For the internet, this means that where there is transparency, we are able to look behind the logo, which is very powerful. JPEG can't do this, because JPEG doesn't support transparency. I go to File, Export As. Let's first look at JPEG. As soon as I click on the preview button, I see the transparent background is filled in with white, meaning we lost the transparency. Also, JPEG quickly gives artifacts. At quality 90, we already see a lot of JPEG compression. The file size is 21 kilobyte. Now let's go to PNG. I press cancel. With PNG, the artifacts are gone and we have transparency. With JPEG, the file size was 21 kilobyte and with PNG, the logo is 14 kilobyte. So PNG not only provides transparency, it also has no artifacts, and for logos and icons, it even gives a smaller file size. In the next lecture, we will look at how to save for print.